Let me show you how we can evaluate this infinite series, n going from 1 to infinity of n over 2 to the n times cosine of n pi over 3. Okay, let's think about this a little bit. What if we didn't have the cosine of n pi over 3? In fact, we did that before, and there are many ways to do that. And perhaps the most straightforward way is to start with our best friend, aka the geometric series. So it's a formula. Differentiate that, so get another formula, and we can figure that out, right? So, I'm actually going to start with that. However, though, here we do have this cosine part. So the idea here is that we will borrow complex numbers to help us out. So let me show you how we can do it. So first, though, I'm going to write that. If we have the series as n going from 1 to infinity, z to the nth power. The reason I use z is because later on, I will be using complex numbers. This will be the first term is z to the first power, so it's z, over 1 minus the common ratio, which is z, like this. Okay, I am going to differentiate both sides so we can bring the n to the front. So let's go ahead and do that. So on the left-hand side, bring the n to the front and then minus 1. We will have the series as n going from 1 to infinity, and then n times z to the n minus 1. On the right-hand side, well, just use the quotient rule, and you'll get the derivative. I will tell you the answer. The bottom squared, and then the top is just going to be 1. Okay. Now, there's one condition we have to be careful, because in order for this to work, and that means in order for this to converge, in order for this to be legitimate, the condition is that absolute value of z has to be less than 1. So keep that in mind. Likewise, we have the same condition here. So keep that in mind. Okay. Now what though? Okay, let's fix this a little bit because we just want n, not n minus 1. So I will just multiply both sides by z. So ladies and gentlemen, we get a formula, the sum as n going from 1 to infinity. When we multiply by z, it's just z to the n minus 1 times z to the first power, add the exponents. It's just n z to the n. And on the right hand side, we just put a z to the top. So that's z over 1 minus z squared. All right, very good. But we will have to think about what z that we are going to plug in right here in order to end up with this expression. Well, the reason I brought up complex numbers is because when we have the cosine part, right? And we will also need to use the idea from perhaps the most important formula, well, Euler's formula in complex analysis. E to the I theta is equal to cosine theta plus I sine theta. We have the cosine part. And the idea is that cosine is just the real part of this. Very nice, huh? So, what z are we going to plug in? Well, let's think about it. We have the n right here already. And then this has 2 to the n on the bottom. Z should have a 2 on the bottom, huh? So let's start with 1 half. Okay, and then we have this cosine, and then this has an n, and then pi over 3. Cosine, again, it's the real part of e to the I theta. So I will just put e to the I with theta being pi over 3. That will work. And I will plug in this in here, but I want to figure out like the real part and also the complex part and then the exact value for them. So I will write this in the standard form. So this is 1 half cosine of pi over 3, which is 1 half, and then plus I sine of pi over 3, which is square root of 3 over 2. Again, this is cosine of pi over 3, and this is sine of pi over 3. So now, I will plug in this into here. We get the series as n going from 1 to infinity, n times 1 half e to the I pi over 3 to the n. this being equal to, plugging all this into this and that. So we have 1 half times 1 half plus I square root of 3 over 2. And then over 1 minus 1 half times 1 half plus I square root of 3 over 2. And then square. Okay, here's the deal. This right here is just going to be some algebra. You know, multiply the 1 half, simplify this, expand the square, and then multiply the top and bottom by the conjugate and put that into its standard form. I will have a separate video for you guys. Right here, I'll just tell you guys the answer for that. We will end up with negative 1 third plus I square root of 3 over 3 after you work that out. On the left hand side, this will give us precisely the series as n going from 1 to infinity, n, and then over 2 to the n, and then this right here is e. Because n is a positive whole number, because n going from 1 to infinity, so we can just multiply the exponents. So it's e to the I n pi over 3. So if you work this out, you will end up with negative 1 third plus I square root of 3 over 3. But what does that tell us though? Well, this is the real part of the result. And the real part of this is precisely the one with the cosine, right? If you have the cosine of n pi over 3, which will give us that, times n over 2 to the n, we know that summation must be negative 1 over 3. Likewise, you can also do it with sine, but I'll leave that to you. So right here, I'll just write this down. This tells us that the summation as n going from 1 to infinity, n over 2 to the n, just the cosine part of that, which is cosine of n pi over 3, this will be just the real part of this, which is negative 1 third. And that is the answer. Very cool, isn't it? We use complex number to help us solve something totally real. And that will be the answer if you change the cosine to sine. That's it.